7 hours into the race, 7 searing hours beneath the blazing sun, on roads more suited for animals. It's a most unlikely duo, the undisputed superstar of triathlon, fighting for his title against a shepherd in a battle that no one, especially Mark Allen, would have expected. Behind by a mile now, the man who was supposed to be alongside Mark Allen can seemingly go no more. The effects of the surgery and the demands of the race have all but stopped Greg Welch, who must now bear the thought that he is being passed by others left behind long ago. And what must Allen be thinking now? He too expected the Australian to be his running mate this far into the race, but instead wonders how he can shake Bustos, who has relentlessly maintained his pace. Welch wanted this to be the day that all doubters were silenced. No longer content to be just the newest star, he had to win this Ironman to achieve the success and the respect of his peers. That goal will remain elusive another year, at least. Up front, Allen shows the first signs of surging, having long ago forgotten the man who came to beat him. Welch is simply trying to hang on, not only to what is left of the race, but of his pride as well. Allen continues to press on. Like a prize fighter boasting of a knockout round, he claimed before the race that he would make his move between the 7 and 8 hour mark. He is looking to make good on that prediction. Welch, having abandoned all hope of fighting for the lead, musters the courage to simply walk on. What now of the free spirit who approached every challenge with a smile? What now of the man who was supposed to finally beat Mark Allen? Now, Allen shows why he is known as the Grip. All who dare to challenge him fall into his grip of death. And Bustos is only his latest victim. Welch just hopes to make any contact at all as he confronts the loneliness of the open road. Those who witnessed this Ironman recall this day. They will speak of the clash of cultures which went head to head, and how Mark Allen once again seemed to get stronger as the race wore on. Greg Welch will have to hear about it, like the others who were too distant to witness it for themselves.
No one with a real hope of winning a race allows a gap like this to open up. Kristen Bustos is failing to respond to Mark Allen's move. Biggest title of the year. Bustos used to idolize Mark Allen. Now he's barely clinging to a slim hope of beating him. With the turn completed, the athletes can, psychologically at least, think of themselves as headed toward home, the finish line at Kailua Pier. But first, a detour. sadistic 3-mile out and back visit to a place most improbably known as the Energy Lab. But at age 34, Alan says experience helps him deal with the ups and downs of an 8-hour race day. Right now, he's off. And Busto seems to have lost his rhythm and seems to be suffering from the heat. Alan runs with an added spring in his step. He calls the true test of an athlete not a single victory, but a series of big race wins. Earlier this year, Alan won his 9th straight Nice Triathlon. Now he's headed toward a record 4th straight Gatorade Ironman victory. Bustos thinks about next year while Alan plans his victory speech. With the win all but assured, only Alan's own course record stands unvanquished.
And as he heads